Thank you. I've been muted the whole time. Well, anyhow. Okay, so. Oh, I thought I had turned on the replay. Well, guess not. Anyhow, to recap some of what I've said to a turned off microphone, AL81 is a cherry ginger ale. It's supposed to have a citrus flavor to it, but for the most part, I just taste the cherry juice and the ginger ale, and it is like real cherry juice flavor, not candy cherry. So good stuff here. But let me fix something really quick here. Because I thought I had turned on rewind support. Okay. So load state. So the last couple of times we tried to get the black stone here, just outside of Moonglow, I thought I had to wait until I could enter the Moongate, see the screen flicker, and then search. But apparently all I have to do is search as the Moongate is opening. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. All right, search. You find the black stone. There we go. Okay. So we're good as far as that's concerned. Let's actually jump in. All right, so we're outside of. Guess I should have paid attention to where I'd be going. This must be Jellum. Okay, so we either want a boat or to go to Trinzic. The best way to get to Trinzic. Would be to go to Magincia, which would be the second tick of the Jellum Gate. Now, if we get a boat, there are a couple of other things that we can do, but I'm not holding my breath. Boat tends to really be picky as to when it shows up. Okay, so there's the gate. Wait for tick two. Right, now we're outside of the Magincia ruins. And here we'd want to do tick one. This is the best place to find a boat, but we don't necessarily need a boat to, there's only one set of, one dungeon left for us to do that does not require the boat. Whoops. Ah, crap. Iolo! Why'd you have to go and get yourself poisoned? Let's go over here instead. Picked up a bunch of reagents. Stocked back up on food. Hopefully, we don't run into any more gremlins in the other dungeons, because that was a. God, I felt that I was so prepared, and then they ate all our frickin' food. Okay, here we go. And pop through. There's Trinzic. Okay. I had this music stuck in my head the other day. And since it's a short loop, it was really dangerous. Okay, so from Trinzic, we can go west and slightly north. From the Trinzic Gate at least. To the Dungeon of Destard. Okay, and I am going to not take any chances here. We're going to save the state and bring up dungeon map. Okay. Perfect. Okay. So we're in kind of an endless loop here. Sort of, but you can see the very small pixel that's missing there. There we go. Floor two. Okay. So I think we just need to go north. And then west. Hello, bats. Man, it's nice to have the just everybody outfitted with crossbows. Well, except for Anakev, because he can't use a crossbow, he still has to use a sling. Light spell, if I remember correctly, was just the sulfuric ash. Success! Okay. Cast spell. Light. Perfect. Do, 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 do. Okay. Wait, that's right. I know how the targeting works, I just keep forgetting. Okay, and you go with that, there we go. How about you go with that one? There we go. Okay, how are we doing? Okay, we're not doing too bad. Good, good. I'd like to see those Nixie bulbs. It was a really sloppy geek joke, but eh. Had to make it at some point. Come on, get him. Here we go. Perfect. Okay, let's just go. Okay. On to floor 3. Okay, so we need to go through that door. We could just go straight across. So I don't really know that I want to bother with the magic balls. I haven't so far. This is not going to take long. There we go. Okay. Okay. Down to level 4. Now here, I may linger a bit because there's a ton of treasure chests. Okay. Can I? Oh, there is stuff I can attack. Okay. What the hell? They're all moving. Phantoms? Okay. Well, let's just try to take them out. Okay, we're doing fine health-wise. They're not, like, wiping us out or anything. What sucks is that I am going to have to heal myself at some point in this dungeon. And I'm going to have to come back through this room later. And I should probably look into configuring a turbo button. Because I can't just hold down the button for this. Come on. Almost got it. There we go. And we want to go this way. And look at all that cheddar. Okay. Whoops. Now, when I left the last dungeon, I had something like 2,500 gold. And then I had to use quite a bit of it just to restock. Mostly for food. Oh no, it delivered 6 points of damage to me! Oh, the pain. Can I camp in here? Oh, I can! Oh, that's fantastic. Okay, good. Okay, well, that's much better. Not perfect, but it's much better. Man. Look at all this cash. I really do wish that the treasure chests would sometimes hold objects. They don't really seem to. It's always cash, never reagents or weapons or armor. And fortunately, these chests are not considered stealing. Jeez, I think I've gotten over 1,000 gold just in this area. Is that a mimic? It is not. Okay. Get the chest. Awesome. I just wasn't sure if getting the chest in battle would do something different, but it doesn't seem like it did. Like, if I got the chest that was in battle, that it was somehow different from the chest that was on the world map. Oh, crap. Go away, gremlins. Hey there, Garlic. Welcome, welcome. And yes, I am actually an avatar right now. I'm a full 8-part. I'm currently working on getting all the stones and staying the hell away from these gremlins so they don't eat my food. Thank you for the follow, Garlic. Much appreciated. Haha, good. There we go. This is just a ridiculous amount of cash, but that's good. Well, I'd like to say that, but it seems like it's still quite a ways away. I have three of the eight stones? Yes, I have the yellow, green, and black stones. You know, I'm on my way to get the fourth, but the others require boats to get to, which I have had the worst luck trying to get boats in this campaign. But this is the first time I've ever played this game. I'm really kind of enjoying it. I think I'd probably enjoy it more if I wasn't streaming. Because I'm trying to streamline a little bit of what I do. I did a little bit of offline stuff, but I'd probably have done a lot more grinding and be a lot better equipped by now if I was just playing this on my own. Yeah, you need to wait until a pirate ship happens by, and then, you know, you take the pirate ship. And somehow that's considered virtuous. But getting the pirate ships to spawn in the first place has been a problem. Fortunately, I've got everybody equipped with crossbows, except for my main character, the mage, who's got a sling. Because he can't equip a crossbow, because he's a punk. Alright, we're just going to let him kind of nap there. Ah. There. Oh, now he's awake. Hey, you guys! Take me with you! I want to go to Hollywood, too! Yeah, basically. I mean, you get positive virtue for defeating evil enemies, so I guess it makes sense. Okay, so how are we doing? We're doing okay-ish. Alright. Level 5. Where is the stone here? I think it's the red stone in Death Star. Yep, redstone. Okay, it's on the 7th floor. Also, on my live streams, I sample unusual foreign or craft sodas. Tonight is Cherry Ale 81. It's a cherry ginger ale with, and it's like real cherry flavor, not like candy cherry flavor. So it's really good. You can see all the stuff that I've sampled over the past year and a half or so. and what I've got in the fridge, because one of my channel point rewards is to select which of the sodas that are in my fridge I will drink next. Okay. We are on the fifth floor. Okay. Take the west staircase first. Oh, but I haven't been messing with the magic balls, so I don't need to do that one. So let's just go north and west and... Oh, crap. More gremlins. Hey there, Infamous. Welcome, welcome. How are thee and Kitty? Ha! Eliminated! Okay, I don't need to go through that room. Oh. Hi, Siren. So, funny story. The other night I was recording some audio for a video, and she jumped up here. I think she knows when I'm streaming, and she wants the attention. Hi. Goofball cat. Okay, let's start focusing a little bit better here. There we go. Ah, that's fine. There we go. Good, good. Now I think we can safely just rapid fire. There we go. Stay away from me. Okay. Floor 6. Yeah, that's easy enough. Do. Okay. I think I need to go this way. Yep. And we want to go through that door. Oh! I got to go through a door and didn't have to fight? Imagine that! Yay! Redstone! Okay, so let's go ahead and rest up for a moment. Alright, we're actually... Wow, look at that. We got up to full health. We've still got 448 food. Now, apparently... you can... Whoops. Gotta mix some more light magic here. Let's do 3 right off the bat. Now, apparently you can just skip right between dungeons from here. You just have to make it up to the altar room. So... So let's go up to the altar room. That's or down to the altar room. That's on the 8th floor, and see if we can just go from there directly to the next dungeon. Because that would be convenient. I wouldn't have to go hunting for a boat. Okay, light. I could just use a spell to go back up or down or whatever. Oh, crap. But I feel pretty confident here that we can do it safely. We haven't really run into anything that's giving us too much trouble. I mean, the biggest thing I've been fearing have been these gremlins. They go down easily enough. I just don't want them touching me. Steal my food. Oh, hello, bats. Oh, and a rat. Oh, they're insects. Okay. I don't know, using a crossbow to take out some insects seems to be overkill, but you know what I like to say, overkill is underrated. I mean, it's pretty damn impressive they're actually hitting those insects with their crossbow bolts. That's skill. Okay, so now we need to go through this stairwell. And then we should be able to just go up and around. Now, I don't like the look of that guy. Anything new and unusual concerns me. So I think after I'm done with this fight, I might do a save state. There we go. Okay, just to be safe. There we go. I'm not proud. Okay, we are going to be focused here. Okay. Ah! I was just about to say, well, you know, if I can take them out in a single round, there's very little that they could do that would endanger me in, you know, less than a round. Then it stuns most of my party. All right, let's kind of try to advance a little bit on him so we can hit him more reliably. There we go. Okay. All right, that could have been much worse. There we go. Okay. Is there some sort of... Nope. Welcome back, Siren. You gonna stick around this time? Show everyone that fine ass. You know, I think people would rather see your face. Rather than your disturbingly distinctive pucker. Hi. Okay. Now we just need to get past this guy again. Let's see. Can I sneak into the stairwell? Nope. Okay. I mean, if all they really do is stun me, that's not a problem. don't really seem to do any actual damage. There we go. Okay, now we are on the 8th floor. Okay. Okay, so I just kind of want to go north. There's some lootable rooms downstairs, but I really don't want to risk that. So let's just go northly. Ah, and there is the altar room. Okay, good. Get these mages before they start causing any trouble. Okay, good. So, this altar. Let me see if I can actually trigger it properly. So you need 4 gems to trigger an altar. I don't have the correct 4 gems for any single altar. So right now I've got red, yellow, green, and black. You need at least the white gem, which I don't have for every one of these. I'm close to the one for love, but that needs the orange gem, so no luck there. So, what we can do, though, is exit what does it say? Exit west to get to the dungeon called Shame. Which saves us the trouble of finding a boat to get there. Bye-bye, Siren. Okay, so now we are on floor 8 of the desert of the dungeon called Shame. And that we have to go all the way up to the 2nd level of the dungeon to get the purple stone. That's fine. We have maps. Okay, so we need to just go south here, through this door. Ah, what are those? I don't like. Dragons! Fun! Okay. That didn't hurt too much. Okay, we've killed a dragon. That's a nice boost to my morale. Not taking too much damage. I think we can safely accelerate here. Alright, cool. Oh, okay. That wasn't as scary as I thought it would be. Okay. Gotta get everybody down here. Oh. Okay. Actually, we need to go this way. Getting there. Ah. Oh, dang it. There we go. Now we can just skedaddle. Okay. Now we just go around here. Insects! Really? Oh crap. Gazers. Get those out of here, because I don't want to find out whether... I was going to say, I don't want to find out whether they can petrify me or not. Jeez. These enemies have just been cutting me off all night tonight. Let me get my observations out. You're living eyes. You should understand this concept. Walking eye, Hank. So glad I can kind of take them out from across the board if I want to. Don't have to waste time moving. Oh, right! Anakev can't open it because he's stunned. Okay. Compared to which? The PC version? Because I haven't played any version of this. When I was kind of deciding to play an Ultima game, even before I knew about this game's unique premise, I was like, Ultima 4 is the only one on this, only Ultima game on this, on a Sega console. Let's give that a shot. I did get the entire collection on Good Old Games when it was on sale, so I've got 1 through 9. And I've got all of the console Ultima games on hand. I'm playing this on an emulator, but I do own the cartridge. That's kind of my personal rule. I only emulate what I actually own. Oh, really? Ugh, that sucks. Alright, let's take out some vermin. I don't want to know what these do if they get close. other than attack. Ha! I've rid myself of my verminity. It sounded better in my head. I think this one I got on eBay. Most of the rest, we have an embarrassment of riches of used video game stores in southern Wisconsin. And actually, one of the cartridges I got, Ultima 7 for the Super Nintendo, I actually got that in the Twin Cities when visiting my sister once. But all the other Game Boy and NES and Super Nintendo games I got around the area here. But I think this one I did have to find on eBay. I just wasn't finding it in person. It's got the case and the cartridge, but none of the inserts. Okay, there we go. Seventh floor. You know, Anakiv is the only one who's been damaged. Let's rest anyway. Can someone put out the light spell? Okay. Where are we now? I think we're right there? No, this doesn't make any sense. Do 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 do. Okay, that makes sense. Okay. Okay, so we can just go straight through here. But then here, rather than going straight to the right, I want to go up here. There's a hidden path. We are going to take you out. Run! Okay, now it's gotta kind of start congealing again. There we go. Treasure! I wish it was not quite so annoying to grab treasure chests, but look at all that cheddar. And this after having so many problems getting money in the first place. Like, I had to grind quite a bit just to get everybody their crossbows and improved armor, such as it is. I mean, Julia's the only one in the team who can wear anything better than leather. Oop. Hey, who turned out the lights? Gotta turn it back on before the Vashta Narada get us. Don't feel bad if you don't get one of my references. I would be shocked if anyone gets all of my references. Well, worst part is I'm a mage. So, like, everyone else in my group at least can wear leather armor. I'm stuck with cloth and a slingshot. Okay, this could be annoying. It's all of those bastards trying to stun me every turn. Okay. Get him! Thank you! Oh no, they're casting other spells now too. Will you cut that out? And yet if I run, I'm the coward. Whatever happened to discretion being the better part of valor? Jeez. There we go. Should keep us going a little while longer. Oh, damn it! Stop it! Hey, Adrex. How's it hanging? I have to run. Or hide behind the person who's passed out. That's a viable option. Stop putting my party to sleep. Thanks for being a meat shield, Julia. Only problem here is I don't want Julia to die. No way to bring her back. Screw it. Okay, you know what? Dang it. Okay. Didn't save my mapping to... map the rewind button. Where is it? Where is it? Input. There we go. Port 1. L2. Oops. That's not what I meant. Ah, crap. Where is it? Hotkey. There we go. That's what I wanted. Rewind. There we go. Resume. And rewind. Outburst! Outburst! So, you can rewind in the emulator. So I'm going to do that. It's going to take a while. It's not rewinding very fast. Well, yes and no. These guys have this annoying trick of stunning everyone pretty much every turn, and there's so many of them that it just goes off all the time. And if I leave, if I run away from the battle, I lose my avatar hood. I have to regain my valor. So, what I'm hoping to do is revert to before the battle started, save state, see if maybe I get an RNG where I don't run into quite as many of these things, but I also need more healing spells so I can hang in the fight better. I was going to say, no, soda list, not socialist. Your autocorrect is a damn commie, Drex. Tonight's soda was Ale 8-1, which is, and it's cherry flavored. I've had Ale 8-1 before, which is ginger ale. But this had a really good, like, real cherry juice flavor to it. Rather liked it. See, look at all that crap. Most of my party spent most of the battle sleeping. And the only person that seemed to be able to resist it was the one person who's, like, least able to take everything on his own. Haha! Virtue in Ultima 4 that has to do with cheating the hell out of it. Come on. Keep going. So I watched Agretsuko when it came out. I thought it was kind of hilarious. I don't tend to watch that many anime, but that one had kind of an interesting premise to it. And I've been looking forward to that. Let's see here. So, yeah, I'll mark that as tomorrow night's drink then. Let's see here. Ramune, Agretsuko, Bloody Grapefruit. Yeah, I saw that one and I'm like, okay, I have to try this. Yeah. So you're getting used to referring to her as your wife rather than your girlfriend? How many times have you slipped up on that? Okay, so first things first. We're going to go ahead and save state. Then we're going to mix reagents. And heal is ginseng and spider silk. Let's mix 10 of those. There we go. And do we want to try resting here? Yeah, I think I do. Nice. Nope. We did get ambushed, but shouldn't be too bad. The only problem is that this means that we didn't actually get rest, but we'll just move on. Okay, There's only four this time. Although Julia and Iolo are still stunned from the ambush. Let's see if we can actually pull this off. Because I think last time there were like seven of them. Yeah, we're doing better this time. Come on. Yeah, let's move up a little bit. Come on, get him. There we go. Okay. Annika is poisoned. Let's go ahead and take care of that. Excellent. Definitely gonna save after that. Okay. Now, let's get back to our looting, shall we? Is there a maximum amount of gold I can carry? Like, am I limited to 9999? Because I'm getting... I was going to say I'm getting close, but I'm only like halfway there. Oops. Nope. I saw that little bastard. Stay away from me and my food. Well, mixed blessing there, because I don't get to, I don't really get to catch your streams very often. I find it really difficult to watch streams while I work. I've tried to do it a couple of times and it just doesn't work out very well for me. But I also don't get to raid you. But I am glad to see you in my stream. That's cool. Okay, cast spell, cure Anikev's poison. There we go. Almost cleared out this area. One more. There we go. Oh, Shamino's stunned. Okay. Now that we've cleared that out and got like 2,000 or so gold, let's find the map. And want to go back up. The next floor just has a description of this floor is free of dangers or puzzles. Ah, that'll be a nice change. Okay. Get everybody over here. Excellent. Move through there. Okay. It's only one gremlin. He ain't gonna get to my food. There we go. Let's get the chest. Fair enough. And, you know, for this to, on a normal night, I go to bed around 12:30. On my streaming nights, I end my stream at about 11 o'clock. So that's still enough time for me to get to my normal bedtime and, you know, keep a normal habit. So that was one of the things that was kind of crucial to getting me to resume streaming after I took a fairly decent hiatus, was to find a good schedule that worked for me that wasn't working against me. So whatever works for you, I'm happy you found that balance. Okay, so I want to go... Yeah, let's just go towards the gremlins. Those haven't been too much of a problem. There was just that one room that we ran into last week where the room was literally full of gremlins with us in the middle of it. And they just chomped down on all of our food. That's understandable. I guess I don't get raided that often, so... I mean, there have been some times when I've gotten raided right before the end, and I just kind of hold on for a little bit longer, but... Again, I have like an hour and a half of leeway between when I normally end a stream and when I start to head to bed. And even then, my bedtime, like when I really need to be asleep, is 1:30. Okay, so here we go. Yeah. Through this door and just right up. Okay. Five rooms form a crossroad. Magic orbs and fountains. Okay. So we'll want to go to the south. Oh! The exit to the dungeon is on the fourth floor? Weird. You know, it's kind of weird the way it works in that... What the hell? Who's over there stunned? But like... I'm not gonna say I don't want to stream, but there are some nights when I'd rather not. But, you know, I have this reasonable schedule that I want to keep to, and it is a solid schedule, so people can kind of schedule around it too for their lives. So I kind of feel obligated to stick to my schedule, but that kind of also helps to, you know, keep it somewhat limited. So it kind of balances, you know, it gives me that last little oomph to actually stream when I'm feeling not quite like I want to stream. And it also kind of reins me in when I'm like, man, I could go for 5 more hours! Yeah, and I was flying by the seat of my pants for like the first year or two that I was streaming. I love this schedule thing that I've worked out. It just feels better. Okay, I'm gonna send someone over there to check on whoever that is. lying there. Oh, fair enough. I mean, to each their own. I can understand how that would, you know, potentially rub someone's personality the wrong way. For me, because I've got, like, my my stream plans and everything, it gives me something to look forward to. Okay, well. So, like, you know, next month, I'm really looking forward to finally diving into the Nintendo 64. Because I really haven't touched that console very much at all. Like, I think the most I've played the Nintendo 64 was last year when I was doing a whole bunch of, like, when I did the steering wheel, peripheral focus. And I played a couple of games there. But no, next month I plan to do, like, one game a night, or maybe even, you know, a couple of nights if I end up enjoying it. I want to go south. Okay. And I'm going to avoid Star Fox because that's the only game on the Nintendo 64 that I've played well, I wouldn't say completion, but finished the game. I've got some interesting titles to poke at. Fair enough. Yeah, I guess it's more of a, I get to do this. But also streaming and, you know, again, different things for different people's personalities. Me, I've been getting into streaming and making YouTube videos to combat gaming on Wii. I would sit there and I'd be like, I want to play something, but I don't know what. And I just wouldn't end up playing anything. And part of that is just the embarrassment of riches of all the games that I have. So it kind of gets me to go through some of the stuff I've got on my shelf and, you know, kind of gives me that push to, you know, I want to play something, but I don't know what. Well, now I know what. Oh, you creep. Get out of that corner. Fair enough. I did not like working retail. I think part of it was because, the major part of it was that when I worked at Walmart, I would occasionally end up in the housewares aisle. And the smell of all of the chemicals was just, it would give me a headache every time. And there was really no way I could say, hey, just don't put me there. Because you go where you're needed. And then after the holiday rush, I wasn't getting any hours anyway, so I got a new job. But I have done some time in retail. Okay. I definitely prefer office work. Feels like more problem solving. It's more entertaining. More engaging. Gives my brain more of a workout. Even when I was just doing normal customer service, it was problem solving. Nice. Dude, you find what you love to do as a job. That's the tricky part. A lot of people try to turn into a job what they love to do as their hobby, and then they start to hate it. Like, for example, streaming, Drex. I bet you're enjoying it a lot more now that you're not, you know, depending on it to make a living. Ah, yeah. But yeah, it's a matter of finding something you enjoy doing as work. I'm finding that I enjoy programming for work. I have not been able to make any progress doing, like, recreational programming. I've got a couple of game ideas, some of which I could conceivably program. It's within my skill set. But I just don't. Nope. Want to get that chest. Okay, I just have to go around the corner. Got it. Oh, wow. Well, I think that would probably... sour one. Like, I love cats, but I feel like two are more than enough. To be perfectly honest, I would probably be happy with just one cat, but I do prefer them having some companion around when I'm not here. Interesting. So now you stick with birds. I hope you don't get burnt out on birds the same way. Okay, now we are on the third floor. Okay, here we just need to leave and go down to the second floor. Yeah, okay, straight up. Actually, there aren't any enemies around here. Let's see if we can rest. Oh, okay, yeah, that's a good point. You're in it more for the rescue rather than, you know, again, making it a job. Yeah, why are you trying to attack those? go. No, there we go. Okay. All right, let's start moving up here. And I will want to leave this room to the west. Okay. There we go. Just clearing out all these slimes. Actually, you know what? That's not a bad idea. Let's split the party. Normally that's a terrible idea, but we're not really splitting the party per se. I mean, we're both in the same room. We're just kind of splitting our efforts. Okay. There we go. Now that's all lined up. Nope, let's get all of them out in the open. Perfect. Okay. Nope, you gotta move over. Nope, keep moving. Okay. Now we're good. Go! Oh, more slimes. Oh yeah, I've been an animal fan myself, but I think being a vet is a special kind of love for animals, because, I mean, you have to see them in pain, and you have to sometimes cause them pain. Not to mention the potential for having to actively put them down. Yeah, I don't think I could be a vet. Okay, there we go. Well, we can avoid that for now, but we'll need some dispel spells. Come at me, bat! There we go. Okay. Just keep going down this way. More slimes. Hadn't checked on my food in a while, but we're still over 400, so we're doing fine. We started the night just under 500, so yeah, I think as long as we don't run into any more gremlins, or, you know, close encounters with gremlins, we'll be fine. More bats! Oh, what are you? You're not a bat. A lava lizard? Well, at least it's heavily wounded. There we go. Got him before he could cause any trouble. There we go. What just happened? I didn't think I was close enough to the bats to be attacked. Okay. Oh, it's dark. Okay. Well, that's fine. Maybe dark, but we were able to find the purple stone anyway. Okay. Okay, let's see here. So we need to go back up to... What was it? Third or fourth floor? Fourth floor. We're on the second. All right, so... First things first. Let's light up the place. And let's just go ahead and send ourselves up a floor here. And I think I know where we are. Oh, wait, no. Might have done the wrong thing here. Yeah, I did. I went up, I was supposed to go down. Well. At least we're right next to the stairs back up. But here, so we don't have to waste all of our, you know, reagents dispelling this stuff. Let's go back. Let's go down. There we go. Now we should go this way and through to, and then back down. To the south. Oh, hi. Okay. Nice job, Anikev. Okay, let's... have you shoot at that one. Shamano and Julia can keep focusing south. Iolo and Jana focus north. There we go. Okay, you'll need to get closer to get to that dude. There we go. Okay, that little corner's cleaned out. Let's get everybody up here. Oh, you can reach that. Good. There we go. Now we got the whole party in range. Ah. Going a little bit faster this time because we were able to start by one of those little enclaves. Ah, wrong way. Nope, you're not gonna hit any of them. There we go. Okay, there we go. Ooh. Wait. I went the wrong way again. Son of a bitch. I needed to go south. Oh well. Yeah, hold on for a sec. Let's pull this trick again. Hey, no problem. Thanks for dropping in. How you doing, DOS Nerd? Okay, there we go. Okay, now we just all go south. That's where I was supposed to go. Okay, there we go, down to level 4. That lich over there kind of reminds me of the Mushusu mask from that one Venture Brothers episode. Love, true love. Well, I guess it kind of has to be if it's geared towards adults. Oh, get your ass over here, you dumbass ghost. Okay, at least it fled. No, I'm kind of tempted to go back up to the altar area to see which dungeons I can go to directly from here. Oh, gotcha. Fair enough. Okay. Alright, so we want to make our way up north through all of this. Enough. Now let's get a third one in there. The other two can just head toward the exit. Okay, now that everything's dead, I can have them leave with no hit to my virtue. Get the chest. Good, good. Oops, go on out. Perfect. Okay. Yeah, I think I started tonight under 2,000 gold. Dungeon diving is fairly lucrative. There we go. Good. It's a twister. It's a twister. That went a lot faster than the first time, too. Almost through. Run! Okay, and through the hidden wall here. Okay. What the hell? Okay. I didn't want to be here. I thought there was an exit to from the dungeon where I was going. I mean, nothing here is likely to really endanger me. Thank you. There we go. Can I attack him when he's... Okay, yeah, I can. Cool. Gotta make sure I don't accidentally step on a poisoned tile. Good. Whoops. Gotta take care of that dancing skeleton down at the bottom there. There we go. Oh, is he fleeing? Okay. Oh, I do have to step in the swamp. Oh. Nope, I can leave without it. Okay, good. There's a secret passage here, but I don't really care to deal with that. I mean, I'm getting close to more money than I can carry. Okay. Okay, where is the path that I took to get in here in the first place? I'm not seeing the, telltale black dot. Oh, there we go. Okay, we're out now. Okay, next problem. Waiting for a friggin' boat. Without stepping on the marsh tiles and getting poisoned. Maybe I should try to... Oh wait, that's right, that's right. They had an a thing for this. Cast a blink spell to the east. I should have the reagents for this. Silkened moss. Okay, so let's try that. Magic, mix reagents, blink, spider silk, blood moss, mix. We'll make two of them. Success. Whoops. Nope. Magic, cast spell, blink. Direction east. Sweet! Okay. What town is this? Oh, Britain! Nice! Well, let's go get some free healing from Lord British here. Because, yeah, I got tons of gold. But I'm not going to waste it on healing if I don't have to. Woohoo, level ups too. Perfect. Okay. Beep 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 beep. Okay. So we've got the red and black, or red and purple stones. Red from Destard. And purple from, which one was that? Shame. The purple stone of shame. So we are now up to 5 of the 8 stones. Good, good. So they've got a couple of things here where you do kind of like what we did tonight, where you go through one, you pass through the altar area to get to a second, and you just go through both of them at the same time. The other two pairs they've got here are ones where I've done one of the dungeons, but not the other. So I will end up probably retracing my steps a little bit, because the reason we've done one of those and not the other is because the other ones would take a boat to get to. So going through the dungeon wrong and using that to get to the dungeon deceit would be a lot easier than trying to boat our way there. Same with Despise and Covetous. So let's see here. Okay. Oh, this will also make it so we can... Oh, they have you go into Dungeon Hyloth first. But let's see here. We'll do that for the last hour here. Because that will give us the white stone, which we need for all of the altar activations anyway. So, and since we're here, apparently there's a quick way to get to Hythloth. Hythloth? Hythloth? Too many ths. From here at Castle Britannia. So, okay, it's describing the... Oh, we need to be told about this, so we'll need to go around to certain locations. Okay. I think we learned about the White Stone. Okay, we're supposed to ask about the White Stone at a bar in Intrinsic. Okay. We'll need to go to Cove, which means we'll need the frickin' boat. Fine, fine, fine. We'll do it. Okay. So we can go to Trinsic. We can, take a portal there. Okay, I'm going to pause for a sec. It pops up crescent waxing. Oh, crap. I don't know how long that's been there. Well, let's jump through and find out. Nope, that's Minok. Okay, so we need to go one more. Nope, that was it. There we go. There's Trinzik. Hooray for rewind. Okay. So we go to the barkeep in Trinzik. The tap. And we need to actually, like, tip him 100 gold. Which would have been a huge pain in the ass before tonight. So, Grog. Nope. We can't give him 100 gold. Do-do-do-do-do. White stone, there we go. Now let me see. Yes, it was the old hermit, Slavin. He is tough to find. I hear he lives near Loch Lake. Lives near Loch Lake, I hear. Okay. So that's telling us to go to Cove. Which, unfortunately, means that we need to find a boat. Dang, it doesn't look like we can buy any supplies here. Well, we can buy food from here. Brown beans, 3 GP apiece. All right, well, let's do 23 plates. Perfect. It's pricier than buying the supplies anywhere else, but that'll at least top us off. Okay. So we're done with Trinzik. Now let's go to... Is this Gibbous Waxing? Yep. Okay. Let's go to Magincia to try to charter a boat. So that would be tick one when the gate opens. And that's Gibbous Waning. That'll be coming up shortly here. There we go. Excellent. Okay. Hello to boat. Hey! Check that out! It worked! Gimme! That's a lot of pirates. That's a lot of nuts! But that's fine, because we've got a lot of crossbows. I hear pirates are weak to crossbows. Stop going for the guy that's hiding. There we go. Go. Yay! We have a boat. Okay, next thing. Check the map. I want to go basically west. And we want to end up in the whirlpool. Just need to find it now. We've seen it once or twice before on this playthrough, but it basically wanders. So I have to wander too. Hey there, Phoenix. Welcome, welcome. We are up to 5 stones. We have yellow, green, black, red, and purple. I am trying to find the whirlpool right now so I can get to Cove. Yep, I did 2 tonight. I got tons of cash because of it. I'm like over 7,000. Hey, there we go. There we go. Okay. Okay. We go this way. Oh. Blocked, huh? Ah, there it is. There we go. Do 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 do. Okay. So the next thing we need to do is talk to Slubbin in Cove. You meet a small druid. I'm Frontis. Welcome to Cove, the hidden city of wisdom. I'm a little banged up. Okay, thank you. Herein is found much wisdom and peace. Except for that sea dragon. I am Brother Zaire. I sit here and watch the river. It flows endlessly. Agree? Yeah. Pretty much. Good! Oh, this looks significant. Nothing here. Thought it said I could find something near the Ankh. I'm the Ankh. I resonate with thoughts. Do you seek help? Yes. What are thy thoughts? Well, I can't really tell you what my thoughts are. Huh. Okay. Well, let's see here. Do Okay. Oh, I can learn the gate travel spell here. Okay, well, let's talk to some more people then. Meet an old druid. I am Draconian. Well, but what's your name? I teach the relation. No, I did not know this. Learn the towns and castles. Whoops. Well, I know it now. Very good! There are 8 possible combinations of truth, love, and courage. Each of the 8 virtues is one of those combinations. Okay. Actually, there's more than 8 combinations of 3 different items, but, you know. We'll go with it. Meet a strangely familiar bard. I am Paul. I play of love. Wilt thou listen? Yes. About love. Ways well now. I light a candle to our love. In love our problems disappear. But all in all, we soon discover that one-on-one is all we long to hear. Sure, whatever. I am Linda. Yeah, I know it's Paul McCartney and Linda McCartney. I sing of the children. All round the world, little children being born to the world. Got to give them all we can till the quest is won. Then will the work be done. Wilt thou help? Yes. Teach them songs of joy. Okay, I don't need to talk to the actual healer, but let's talk to this guy. I am Rabindranath Tagore. I'm not going to ask you your name again. I speak of love. Dost thou seek to carry love in thy heart? Yes, thou art a good soul. I'm old but strong. In love, all life's contradictions dissolve and disappear. Carry love within it. Not that easy. I am Merlin. I use magic. Dost thou study magic? Yeah. Best of luck with thy studies! Okay. Is there anything else over here? Haha. Oh, that's Merlin again. Yeah. Okay. Ah. What are you doing hiding in there? You meet a small boy. I'm Alan. I know how to enter the abyss. Why do you, kid, know how to enter the abyss? The abyss may only be approached by ship. The ship must have a magically strengthened hull. Hast thou such a vessel? No, not yet. Ask Blissful of the abyss. Okay. Okay. Oh! Hold on. That seahorse that's been roaming around is blissful. That's... wow. I would not have guessed that. I mean, I knew who Paul and Linda were. Well, I gotta wait for Blissful to show her face again. Ah, there's Mentorian. I study the magical arts. There is truth in magic. Dost thou disagree? No, I don't. Good! Give me the gate spell. Since thou dost bear the Ankh, I shall tell thee. A gate spell requires ash, pearl, and mandrake root. I don't have any mandrake root. Because it can't be purchased. But at least I know the spell now. Okay, well, now that I know I want to see... oh, there she is. Okay. Come back, Blissful. Oh. More people to talk to. I am Shaman. It's not your name. I study the one thing that is the secret to the Codex. I study of the Codex. The one pure axiom is more endless than the changing tides, more eternal than day and night. Okay. Fair sorceress. So your name's Shaman too? Oh, your charm. I'm charmed to meet you. Yeah, I get that all the time. I ponder the key to the axiom. Yes, that. Oy, these people are thick. You meet a slender mage. I am spellbind. I know of the Codex. One must know the combination of the three principles of virtue. The combination of the three principles of virtue equals the measure of time and space. Meet a wise mage named Circe.
I am Circe Nightshade. Do you seek Azrael Abyss?
The whole of the axiom is greater than the sum of its parts. The measure of unending love, the limitless courage needed to face all obstacles, the truth which encompasses all things. Okay, lovely. That's beautiful. I'm not sure how useful it is, but okay, very poetic. Man, I've wasted a lot of food here. Alright, let's leave and come back and see if that'll reset Blissful's position. Yep, there she is. Come back. There we go. You meet a majestic seahorse. She says, I am Blissful. Not Blissanobiarella? Okay, I know much of the Codex. How's your health?
I'm doing well.
Good. The Shrine Ankh knows how to enter the chamber of the Codex. Meditate at the shrines of honesty, compassion, and valor for 3 cycles to know how to enter. Okay. Dang it, you're supposed to tell me about the frickin' ship wheel. To enter the Codex Chamber, one must be 8 parts avatar, have the key of 3 parts, the word of passion, and know the pure axiom. Or have a fac handy. Huh. Okay. So I think that's all we can do here. So let's see if we lost our boat or not. Yep, we lost our boat. Son of a bitch. Let's see if it'll let us blink north. Right into the swamp. And into an area that I can't get out of. Okay, let's do one more blink. Okay, cast spell. Let's cure our poison first. Another blink, that's silk and moss. I know, right? I just have no luck with those boats. Blink, north. Okay. That seems to have taken me a fair distance. But I'm at least in an area where I can walk to a town. Tempted to go to Minok. But then I'd just be going to Britain anyway. It's about the same distance. Down a bit. Hi, mages. Well, and I don't even know that that's necessarily a bug from the corruption either. Because it's... I mean, it does show up. And earlier I did actually get a boat fairly quickly. I just don't know why it keeps disappearing on me. And it doesn't always disappear either. Okay, so let's go west and do south. I hate this map. Okay, let's move up this turn. Interesting. Okay. It's kind of a weird glitch, though. Like, maybe it's actually there and I just don't see it? But I don't see why the only manifestation would be that. Like, I should be having more glitches if something that critical was going to be showing up, instead of just the few minor graphical glitches I'm running into. There we go. Whoops. Nope. Ah. Now, get chest, open chest, 13 gold, woohoo. Alright. Now there's also supposed to be someone here that tells us something useful. Two characters in Castle Britannia, Joshua and Juliet, spoke of an axiom riddle. Oh, but that Spellbind Shaman Cersei and Charm told me that part, so I guess we got that. Zorin in Castle Britannia. Okay. So we need to find Zorin. No, not really. Well, I mean, if I enter a town and a mob is near me, it's usually not there when I leave town. But I just kind of assumed that that was a reset sort of thing, and not unusual. Well, while I'm here, I might as well get some free healing. Probably wouldn't be the guard. Need a person with a white hat. I am Le Chef. I don't find it funny. Another Le Chef. Okay. Out of my way. Thank you. Why doesn't Le Chef give me food? Okay, that's just a normal jester. Sheila. That's Seisha. Let's go through here. Water. That's Sean. Out of my way. Thank you. Locked doors. Well, let's have a look inside. I think I've got some keys on me. Nope. Dang it. Need a grim shepherd. I'm Landry. I'm here to warn thee. Ahead lies a perilous place. Once thou enters, thou may not return whence thee came. Wilt thou go on? Sure. Then thou art doomed! Okay, that's where I came from. Got it. Ah, dang it. Another locked door. Okay. I need to come back here with keys. Oh, hello. Who are you? Joshua. I can help. The riddle. If the eight philosophies of avatarhood combine into and were made from truth, love, and courage, or, yes, what one thing creates and is created by all truths, all love, and all courage? I don't know. What is it? Blah. Is there a secret path to the west at all? Not seeing one. Nope. Okay, so I need to find some keys and come back here. Vesper or Buccaneer's Den. Okay. Well, I can get to Vesper somewhat easily. I could get to Buccaneer's Den a lot faster, provided I could find a boat. Oh, wait, hold on. Will this take me to Minok? In tick 2 it will. Good. Okay. Well, that'll get me close to Vesper. Well, looks like we're going that way then. Ow! Cut it out! Okay. Go pretty much straight west. Fine! You wanna play? We'll play! Do-do-do-do-do. Thank you. Good, good. Now we can whip them out. There we go. Okay, get the chest. Okay, now we are in Vesper Village. Oh, we can buy the sextant here. Cool. Avast, ye mate. Sure ye wishes to buy from old Long John Leary. Welcome to the guild shop. Yes. Alright, we don't need torches. We're fine on that. We don't need the magic gems. We've got maps. We do need keys. Yes. And... yes. And we'll just do one more first to be safe. Oh, I can't buy anymore. Okay. Okay. Option 4. So, you want a sextant? Well, I got one, which I might part with for 900 gold. Yep. Cool. I don't think I even needed that, but at least I've got it. Okay. But the main thing I needed were the keys. So we got that now. Yes, I would like to buy more arms. Daggers, slings, bows, flaming oils. Nope. Don't need any of that. Hi, Jesha. Welcome, welcome. Alright, let's rest up here. And head back to Minok. From there, we will try to get back to Britain, which I think is a direct teleport from Minok. Nope. We'd have to go through Trinsic first. Okay, so Minok portal pops up at the full moon, which unfortunately we just missed. Well, fortunately, if we're gonna go that route, I do have two arms and two cats, so correct proportion there. Sometimes I even pet my cats with my feet. And as you could see from the picture I posted earlier today, sometimes that does not go well. Okay, we're waiting for a full moon, which should be popping up shortly. Then we will want tick two. To take us to Trinsic. Okay, and there it is. And go! Could just walk back to Britain easily from here, but... why? Okay, that's tick one. We need tick three. Okay. Tick two. Nope, that was tick three. Rewind. Go through. There we go. Okay. Let's actually restock our food really quick while I'm thinking of it. Wonder how many people die here because they can't get to the food counter past all these soldiers. I would like 10 packs. Nothing else. Should keep us going for quite a while. You do have a very large cat. Oops. I just want to go ahead and save state here because I haven't done that in a while. Okay. Let's go this way. Through here. Okay, that goes out. We don't want to do that quite yet. I think there was... no. Where was that? Was that out here or was it up here? That was up here. Okay. There it is. Okay. Use equipment keys. Oh, wait, wait. Why are you actually in here then? You could get out easily. I am a reaper. What is your job? I kill adventurers. There is a thing which can kill many. It turns away. Uh-oh. This may be important. Knowledge of it can be found at Buccaneer's Den. Will you seek this thing? Sure. It brings great power. Alright. Let's unlock another door. Who are you? There's Zorin. Right? Okay, what's your job? I am here to help thee. Seek help in the castles. Seek the Lyceum, Empath Abbey, Serpent's Castle. Wilt thou go hither? Yes. Find therein all named Antos, and ask of the bell, book, and candle. I already have the bell and the book, I just need the candle. Oh. I'm a nameless prisoner. What's your job? I have none. Okay. There we go. So I think at this point, now I can go to, like, Empath Abbey and get some useful information on the Candle of Life. But I also want to check this out. Yeah. So this will actually take me to the Dungeon Heightloth, where I can get the Whitestone, I think. But I don't think I want to do that quite yet. I think I do want to go to Empath Abbey really quick. Get that taken care of. Okay, so I need to go to Serpent's Hold. Yep, I'm in Castle Britannia right now. Okay. So, let's see here. Do I want to just walk there? Or do I want to wait for a teleport to you? Yeah, the teleport's not going to take very long, so might as well wait for it. It's going to be a crescent waxing, and it'll be the first tick. Here we go. Bring up a map to guide me, because otherwise it's a pain in the ass. Good, good. Curl around there. Wipe these jokers out. I gotta be careful that I don't run into whatever that was that, like, two-shotted Anakiv last week. Alright, get the chest. Excellent. And just keep going west. There we go. Now we need to find Antos. You meet a small but stately child. Yes, but not from you. Chin up. Hey, you meet a lovely lady. Oh, Susanna. Wise Druid. Brother Antos, you're the one I'm looking for. Tell me about the candle. Thou dost need the candle of love to enter the abyss. Dost thou know where to find it? No. Meditate on love at our shrine. Kay. Gotta find your shrine. Is it through here? Jimmy Locke! I am Diane. What's your job? I counsel those who enter the grove. Herein thou may find insights into love, within thyself or the others here in the grove. Ask the others. Art thou the most loving person? No, but I'll say yes anyway. Well, actually, no. Saying no is probably going to be good for my humility. Strive for love. I am Benjamin. Hey, my newest nephew is named Ben. I relate love and compassion. When the three combine in eight ways, love alone is compassion. Okay. Of the eight avatar attributes, compassion is derived from love alone. Okay. I am Thomas. I'm thinking of love's part in sacrifice. Sacrifice is built upon the motive of love and the ability of courage. Yeah, I guess so. I am Lastro. I follow the spiritual path. My spirituality is not a religion, but a searching to know and improve my own inner being. Well, yeah, that's generally the concept of spirituality. I am Deirdre. I ponder love and justice. Justice is one of the 8 avatar virtues and derives from truth and love. Okay. So I was supposed to, ponder at their shrine. Stranger will be directed to the Ankh of Love in the shrine. Where is their shrine? Is it here? Oh, there it is. Okay. Excuse me, lady. Humlock. I seek salvation. Yeah, actually. I would be so grateful. You know what? I've got quite a bit of cash on me right now. I can only give you up a maximum of double digits. Fine, I'll give you 50. Sure thing. Seek ye the candle of love, for only with it and 2 other parts might thou enter the abyss. Dost thou have it? No, actually I don't. Ask the bard beyond the secret passage. Okay. Oh, I see a secret passage. Doo-doo-doo. And there's another. Can't steal those. Hello, Bard. What is your name? I am Derek, the Bard. Hey, Derek, it's me, Derek. The Candle of Love is found in a secret place hidden off Lock Lake. Alright, so that's pointing me back to Cove. But now that I know about it, now I can actually get it. It's one of those things. But you know what? That's fantastic. Oh, you know what? I was looking in the wrong place, and this one actually tells me where it is. I could have gotten it before when we were at Cove. But I think what I'm going to do is save for tonight, get a frickin' boat offline, and head back to Cove. So let's take a look at who is streaming right now. Okay. Fellow cartridge clubber Red McKnight is streaming Majora's Mask tonight. So let's go ahead and raid him. All right. Well, thanks to everybody for dropping by tonight. Thanks for following me, Garlic. I hope to see you again tomorrow night, 8 p.m. Central Time. I'll pick right up from where we left off tonight to hopefully make some more progress. But rest well when you do. And in the meantime, enjoy Red McKnight.